Hera described the model most frequently used to interpret volcano deformation. The model assumes a point source of pressure change within an elastic half space, as shown in this figure. It applies both to surface deformation due to magma accumulation prior to an eruption where pressure change is positive, or magma withdrawal from a magma body during an eruption when pressure change is negative. The model is commonly referred to as the Mogi model, named after the Japanese volcanologist Mogi, who applied this model to deformation observed by repeated leveling in relation to an eruption in Japan that occurred in 1914. Accumulation of magma inside the crust is modeled as a source of increased pressure, written as delta P, within a spherical source volume in an elastic half space. A point source of pressure refers to the assumptions that the radius of the source, denoted as alpha in this figure, is small compared to its depth d. The depth is measured from the surface to the central depth of the spherical body. Later work has shown that this approximation is valid as long as the ratio of alpha over d to the fifth power is small, so actually it is quite a good approximation. Under these assumptions, the mathematical equations describing the behavior of an elastic material are solved by applying a pressure change at the boundary of the spherical source. No forces are applied on the surface of the half space, so it is free to deform in response to the subsurface processes. Four parameters are needed to fully describe the model behavior. There are three parameters for the location of the source: latitude, longitude, and its depth. The source strength is the fourth parameter. It depends on both the properties of the source as well as the surrounding host rock, that is, the properties of the elastic half space. This model results in a relatively simple surface deformation field that is radially symmetric. It is thus convenient to express the deformation in a coordinate system with a center in the same horizontal location as the surface projection of the source. We can then use a coordinate system where the horizontal distance from the source is on a horizontal axis that we refer to as r. The model predicts both horizontal displacement in the radial direction, directly away from the surface projection of the source center, and vertical displacement, as shown with the equations and graphs in this figure. We use the letter u to denote displacement. Vertical displacement, or the height change, can then be referred to as u subscript z, with z referring to the vertical direction. The horizontal displacement is u subscript r. The displacement depends on the horizontal distance from the source and the depth of the source, as the equations show, as well as the source strength parameter indicated with the symbol C. According to the model, maximum uplift occurs directly above the source and then decays away from the source in a manner dependent on the depth of the source, as shown in the graph. The horizontal radial displacement is zero at the center and then initially increases with distance until a maximum is reached at a distance corresponding to about 70% of the source depth. At further distances, the amount of displacements decrease with distance. These characteristics can often be used when compared to observed deformation on a volcano to locate a pressure source beneath a volcano. If a radially symmetric deformation field is observed on a volcano, the source is located beneath the center of deformation, and the width of the deformation field will give an indication of the depth of the source. The source strength parameter C depends on the properties of the source and the half space, as shown in this figure and equations. Equation number 1 in the figure shows how the source strength scales with the source properties: the applied pressure change times the radius of the source to the third power, as well as properties of the elastic material, its shear modulus denoted with the Greek letter mu, and its Poisson's ratio denoted by the Greek letter nu. In general, it is not possible to separate the contribution of each of these parameters separately. Any combination of these parameters that results in the same value for the source strength parameter will produce the same surface deformation. For example, the radius of the source nor the pressure change can be inferred separately from ground deformation, only its combination, as shown in equation 1. Equation number 2 is an alternate expression, equally valid, as shows that the source strength can also be written in terms of the volume change of the spherical source denoted by delta V. This is a somewhat simpler representation, as it only depends on the volume change of the source and the Poisson's ratio. Seismic studies indicate the Poisson's ratio for the Earth is about 0.25, so this equation allows one to infer the volume change of spherical source from surface deformation measurements. Equation number 3 is another equally valid expression. It shows that the source strength equals the product of maximum surface displacement directly above the source, denoted by h subscript 0 times the depth of the source squared. This equation can be used to infer the source strength parameters from surface deformation fields that can then later be used, for example, together with equation 2 to infer the subsurface volume change. Predictions of the MOGI model when compared to measured surface deformation on a volcano thus provide a relatively simple manner to estimate the horizontal location and depth of a magma body causing a deformation, as well as its volume change, as long as the assumptions of the model are appropriate.